everybody in this in the TikTok stuff.
Yeah.
She was in the parade in September and her lights quit working about halfway through the parade because it was 96 degrees outside and she doesn't like hot weather like that. So. But other than that, she sits here. She does go on a field trip every once in a while to like a storm chasing convention, weather conference. Now there are three other Dorothys that are still in existence today, 26 years later. Number two is in Hutchinson, Kansas at Stratica. It's an underground salt museum. They take you 650 feet below the Earth's surface. They take you on a train ride through the salt mines. It's 68 degrees year-round down there. And in the back, they have, well, they have like a gift shop. And if you go into the back of the gift shop, you'll see movie props like this and movie reels, costumes. And they're actually down there in preservation.
Yeah.
So if something were to happen at the ground level, these types of things would be preserved for the movie studios. There's a lot of weird, fun stuff in Kansas. A lot of people think it's just nothing, but there is a lot to see in Kansas. There really is.
That's what the women girls have
chosen
to go by. Girls, so. Huh? Girls. Well, it's all a matter of preference.
Yep.
It is. Let's get dislocated. Dislocated, you should have to be a good girl. I get your pardon. I can go to the new, but not call the girl. Say yes, ma'am. Good girl.
Does he have like a social media profile or a YouTube channel?
He's a former state of mine.
Oh, okay.
But he's probably, he's probably my oldest former students are in 40s, anyhow.
Okay.
So.
I'm 41, so you were pretty close there.
Yeah. He's opened a restaurant in Ponca City, so his storm chasing
They're behind him a little bit.
Yeah.
Well, the good thing about storm chasing out here is that, you know, you don't always have to do it, but if one pops up, like a big event, you can always just jump in a truck and check it out. Yep. That was the first 10 years of my chasing career, was doing it when I wasn't working and taking care of kids, you know, and getting my kids up and grown. I would chase out in the Ohio Valley and Midwest, and I did that from 98 until about 2007. And then in 2007, I started coming out here to chase.
Anybody
more
here
or there? Yeah, well, some years it's about the same.
Yeah.
Other years, yeah, there's more out here than most years. But
we heard that the house that Don had lived in Ponca City, that she was a little destructive to it.
She was, her dogs.
You heard that too?
That is actually a verified account where she had her dogs and they made a pretty big to do about the whole way that the house was left.
Wow.
Yep, unfortunate.
Unfortunate that the dogs were left alone to do that. Mm-hmm. They probably needed a little more human attention. Yeah,
I would say so.
Maybe
they maybe don't have dogs when you're an actress traveling all over the country.
It's Ponca City, and there's some people who drive over here. It's about an hour.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
And they had to make that commute every day.
Yeah.
When they were here, of course. That was only about 17 days, but still, it's still taking a toll.
Yeah.
Wendell told us that her and Helen had a pretty interesting conversation over the phone one night. They were both in Ponca. They were both struggling. Helen was struggling with the environment, you know, and then Wendell was struggling with her own struggles, she said. That's how she put it. I was just struggling with my own struggles. She's a really, really cool chick, but she said, but Helen called me one night, about 10 o'clock at night, stressed out, you know, didn't know which way to turn at that point. And we talked through some stuff, and the next time I saw her, she said it was a couple days later. She seemed to be in good spirits, but she was still isolated. She would isolate herself for whatever reason. But we thought it was an interesting account anyway. At least, you know, you could tell Helen had a feeling. She really did. She's going to reach out to Wendell and make that phone call. But we don't know what it was like or what they were going through individually. But
Wendell was cool, though. Yeah, she was a cool chick. Her and Sean will be back out. They're actually both have already confirmed with me that they will be back here in 2026 for our 30th anniversary. So we're going to try to literally blow this town up with a couple thousand people and have a big fiesta. And it'll be in May, somewhere around May 10th, 2026. We'll try to get Alan Ruck down here too, which played Rabbit. We're gonna either get him or get Jonas down here. One of the two. Whoever's available in that May time slot, we're gonna try to get down here.
That was Cameron from Ferris Bueller.
Yes,
right?
Yep. And they're both still doing movies. Both Alan Ruck and Carrie Elway's.
How many times have you seen the movie Twister?
I couldn't even tell you. In parts, in full, and as a matter of fact, we actually show it all of our storm chasing tours. Because we have a lot of travel time between chase targets.
Yeah.
So we'll throw it on the tablet and stream it. We stream that, we stream Into the Storm, we stream Day After Tomorrow. There's like two or three other, another one, if y'all haven't seen it, it's called Night of the Twisters. It was made in like 96. It's actually really good for being an almost B-rated movie. It's still pretty good. Because you got the CGI, but you didn't get a good storyline. In Twister, you had a good storyline, but not good CGI. Oh, I got something else that I will challenge you all on next time you watch the movie.
Miss Linda.
I haven't woke up yet, so. But Monday evening, she did. And now she's home. So, not like mom's home and doing good, so. And I'm leaving tonight at 1 a.m.
Heading
that way, yes.
Okay.
Yeah, and we'll be back on the 3rd. So,
okay.
Yeah.
Well, good. I have a favor to ask you, please. Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you.
chair that's back there? Will you take it to my house?
Sure.
Put it on my she shed. She shed.
She shed.
Yeah.
Oh, which chair is it? Well, we can.
We'll go.
Yeah. Can I have something for you? We did have a pair of fuzzy socks for you, but I literally, Andy left, and then I went looking for them and couldn't find them. Anyway. Yeah, but the ones from Ponca, the other two from Florida.
Okay.
Come up from Florida to hang out and see Trister stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah, we've been going at this since about 12, we're out here about 11:50.
So, wow.
Yeah.
Okay.
Guys are still getting it up and getting all the info they can.
I went to bed for lunch.
Did you?
After church.
Oh, nice.
Next Sunday is Christmas.
I know, already it's so fast. I know. What's going on?
I haven't got all my Christmas cards in
that. And you happen to make a couple of yellow anchor specials. Because I ran out of anchor. And I won't buy any more right now because I'm going to make a bunch more until January.
So did you find the book
that has all the stuff in the back?